Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Must Be Stopped, where we delve into the labyrinth and complexities of social media spectacles. Today, we confront the cacophonous kerfuffle between the illustrious Tana Mongeau and the satirical savant, Cody Co. Mongeau has promulgated grave allegations ensnaring Cody in the maelstrom of digital denunciation. As the veritable colossus of commentary, Cody's rejoinder has only amplified the cacophony. This imbroglio, my dear viewers, is a testament to the tumultuous terrain of modern day notoriety. Stay tuned as we dissect the veracity and ramification of this scandalous saga. Until then, remember, something simply must be stopped.
Today we're diving into a topic that's been making waves across social media. We're talking about Tana Mongeau, or Mongeau. I'm not really good at pronouncing her name. I've never been good at pronouncing her name. And her recent allegations against Cody Co. This is a heavy subject, so grab your drinks, get comfortable, and let's get straight into it. So for those who might not be familiar, let's just give a brief background on Tana Mongeau and Cody Co. So Tana Mongeau, or Mongeau, is a well-known social media creator. She has millions of followers across platforms. If you know Tana Mongeau, you know Tana Mongeau. And I'm sorry, I'm just gonna have to call her Tana Mongeau because it's just way too easy. It's way too quick. It's way easier. She's known for, you know, her reputation is known for being outspoken and controversial. She had like a story time arc on YouTube where she just kind of did story times or whatever. She has over 5 million subs, has been involved in various scandals and drama over the years. Cody Co, on the other hand, is a comedian. He's a YouTuber and a podcast host with his witty commentary and satirical takes on internet culture. He has a massive following as well with 500 subs. So both of them have had their fair share of controversies, but recently, Tana has made some serious allegations against Cody that have sparked discussion online across the board. Now let's get into the heart of the matter. Tana took to social media to accuse Cody Co of what is alleged that he slept with her when she was only 17 years of age. These accusations obviously shocked people's minds across the entire platform and have sparked massive debates. According to Tana, Tana claims that at a party, she had initially met Cody there, I believe, and it had been further inferred that they later on in the evening or whenever, later on, sometime in the future, that they slept with each other. Now, these are serious accusations, and it's important to approach this topic with sensitivity and respect for all the parties involved, because it can be a case of an innocent man being falsely accused, but we have receipts. We have evidence. Now, with the following development of the story, Cody didn't stay silent for long. And actually, he responded by playing sorry at his DJ set. So let's look at his response. Okay, so I think this is supposed to be like an apology. So I don't know what this running trend is, but for some reason, when an influencer or any like YouTuber gets caught messing with kids, they apologize in musical compositions. And we can date this back to Colleen Ballinger originally apologizing for, you know, having weird relations with kids that were very, very young and doing things that were very skeptical at hand. She took to social media to apologize by playing a ukulele song. Wow. Yeah. Hey.
I haven't been doing so great, so I took a little break.
Really?
So a lot of people are saying some things about me that aren't quite true.
Oh, really?
It's true, though. Just as long as it's entertaining, right?
Like, what is this?
Driving down the tracks of misinformation, the toxic gossip train. You got a one-way ticket to the manipulation station. Toxic gossip train.
Okay, that's enough of that. So they both apologize in music instead of just sitting down. I guess she has like somewhat of a scapegoat because she did eventually stop singing and just said it verbatim. I don't know, like, what is going on through somebody's head to just apologize in a song? Like, this is a serious accusation at hand. Just apologize or speak the truth or say, like, talk, speak to us. So a lot of people found this actually pretty funny on Twitter and various social media platforms, and Olivia Lopez has a great tweet about this. She says apology DJ son, or what is it, apology DJ son or ukulele apology ukulele daughter or something like that. Something along those lines. I'll put it up right here. You'll see it. So for some reason they do that. I don't know why. Just like, just speak to us, bro. And also Olivia followed me on X. So really appreciate it. But okay, so right here, right? So wait. We're not done. Hold on. So the online community has been buzzing with this drama. You know, the reactions are just like, whoa, wait, is this true? And so the reason we have this evidence, the reason there's so much credibility to these claims is we can date this back years ago. Gabby Hanna herself had been talking about the situation that she originally approached Cody. Oh my God, they're falling apart. She had originally approached Cody at this party that they were at, right? And at this party, she had spotted Cody and Tana kissing each other. And, you know, Gabby Hanna being the vigilante that she so happened to be in this moment, she had to, she had to tell Cody, like, yo, I don't know if you know this, but like, yeah, she may look older, but she's actually 17. It's crazy, right? So Cody goes, okay, that's cool. Okay, thanks for letting me know. Thank you. Now that I'm aware, and you know, it's a bad thing that happened. You know, it's unfortunate that happened, but, you know, he acknowledges, okay? He's aware of her age. And then we get prior information that he went and slept with her the same night. So it was like he disregarded all plausible, like, well, I didn't know, or maybe being on the bush of like, she lied about her age. No, you were fully aware. And so some people's opinions have been divided. Some believe that Tana should be held for accountability, which I don't know how that's even the case. And some believe that Cody is being unfairly targeted. And this has obviously led up to a bunch of heated debates online. And just like in my Dr. Disrespect video, you cannot give these people the benefit of the doubt. They are way too old to have, they're way too old and they've been on this earth way too long to not know that that is not right. These are underdeveloped human beings. These are kids, and it's illegal. And the debate is that in certain states, the age of consent is 16 or whatever. Now that's up for debate. In my personal abode, you should not be messing with, like, if you're too old. Like, why are you even? You shouldn't even be messing with kids who are like young people. In general, and that's just in my humble abode. Like, if I'm 25 and this is a 17, I don't know how old he was. He was like 20 something, 23, 20. Why are you even, what? You don't have an age range near your, you know what I mean? Like, it's just so, I don't know. It's just so like, why?
Why?
And also, and especially in Dr. Disrespect's situation, I mean, he's 35. He was like 30 something, still talking to a 15-year-old allegedly. You just can't be. You can't. There's no scapegoat for you, bro. Like, you can't. You know what I'm saying? You just can't. I'm not even looking at the camera. No, bro. GG's, bro. So what do we make of all this? It's important to remember these are serious allegations and we should approach them with caution. Then now let's analyze the situation a bit more deeply. On one hand, we have Tana's history of being involved in drama, which might make some people skeptical of her credibility. And on the other hand, allegations like these should never be dismissed outright without proper investigation. And now the evidence we have moving forward is this.
I saw him making out with a girl at a party, yeah, who was underage, and I pulled him aside and I was like, hey man, you probably don't know. I know she like looks a little older. She's underage. Watch it. And he's like, oh my God, thank you for telling me. And then he
heard that. Okay, you have to excuse that clip because it's pretty deep fried. But basically, Gabby Hanna basically issued him a citation and gave him an out. She gave him the break. She gave him an option to be like, okay, I may have fucked up, but at least I know now. Now, it is crucial to look at the evidence and not jump to conclusions. In the court of public opinion, people can be harsh, but ultimately, the truth shall prevail. We should consider the potential impact of these allegations for both parties involved. So where do we go from here? It's essentially for both Tana and Cody to address these allegations properly and for any necessary investigations to take place. As viewers and fans, we should remain respectful and avoid spreading misinformation and jumping to conclusions. Now let's hope the truth comes out and both parties can move forward in a positive manner. It's never easy dealing with such serious allegations, and I understand, but it's also important to support those who might be affected in the cause. Now, with that being said, Tana then eventually goes on another podcast where she states how the situation made her feel vulnerable and uncomfortable, and that if she had a figure who was wise enough to let her know how messed up the situation was, she would have been grateful for it.
It is. I definitely am like, why was he doing that? You know what I mean? And there were so many situations. There was a situation with Gabby Hanna at a Playlist Live where she pulled him aside and told him like, yo, she's 17. And then we still went and hooked up. And I can look at that and be like, why were you doing that? But I don't associate or hold it with trauma because I am such a comparative person where I'm like, so many worse things have happened to me.
And you didn't, at that time, it's like, you don't really know what you're doing. And like, you don't really think it's wrong. But again, it's like, he was 25.
25 is crazy, by the way. 25 is crazy.
The thing is like, I still watch his videos. Like, I do think he's really funny. And like, it is this weird thing of like,
yeah, like he does have good videos. It's not like he's not funny or not entertaining.
Harder, or it would be easier and less hard if he was like
easily hateable.
Yeah. Cause I grew up loving him. And I think you know what I mean? Like, I was just like excited and a fan.
So essentially it's like, looking back on it, you know, now she can understand how the trauma may have affected her emotionally, spiritually, maybe even physically. Who knows? Now, for right now, this is still a developing story. We still have not had both parties fully address it. We've only gotten a DJ set and Tana going on a podcast. Now, will Cody respond? We don't know. Like, genuinely respond. And now, I'm not talking about this. It's like these musical compositions that these YouTubers end up doing. It was said initially that Cody lost 180,000 subs within 24 hours, I believe. That's a massive chunk of his audience and a massive chunk of his following. Whether everyone will not watch and not be too deep into the lore and like just not care and disregard it, there will be those few who still watch Cody and they won't even associate it. There might be people who don't even figure it out. There might just be people who they watch Cody and they go about their day. They don't even think about like anything else other than just going about their day. You know what I mean? So in that regard, we're just gonna have to see, okay? We're just gonna have to see. Have to wait for Cody's response. His genuine response, not a DJ set. So I'll keep you updated on this information when it comes out. And if you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell so you can know when all my videos are dropping. And you won't miss any updates. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you believe the allegations? And what do you think Cody's response will be like? What do you think of his initial response? And let's discuss it respectfully. Okay, let's discuss it respectfully. And with that being said, I'll see you when you're up. Peace.